The one and only minister, Annette by way of Parkway Moore. Give her a hand if you come, everybody.
Amen.
Amen.
We was in church yesterday. I was just praising the Lord. Just praising the Lord. Just praising. I got out that little praise. I can't come. I heard my name. I didn't know what he was saying, but I heard Bishop's name. And I was like, huh? He said, what? Oh, who? When? Who? That's what I was. I said, no, and today when he was promising, but I was tired for the day already. I know, Lord. But I come before you, say it's an honor to come before you this evening to speak to you, to deliver whatever God has in me to give to you. And it's an honor that Bishop allowed me to come in the pulpit to speak to you. It's an honor. It's a pleasure. Before we start, I'm just going to go in prayer and get me out of the way. And let God just work through me and let him just speak through me on my tongue, whatever he has through me. Our Heavenly Father, Lord, I come right now, Lord. I'm giving you thanks right now, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
I thank you for the opportunity to be used, Lord. I ask, Lord, that you empty me out right now, Lord, and pour in your substance, pour in your spirit, Lord. Pour in your anointing right now, Lord. Because when I speak, Lord, let the anointing flow off my tongue, Lord. So when it hits the hearts of your sheep that's out there, Lord, their hearts won't be hard and they will open up, Lord, because they'll see that, Lord, that it's you that's speaking to me. I'm just a vessel, Lord, and I thank you for being used at this moment.
Yes. Yes.
So I give you the honor, the praise, and the glory in your son Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, I'm kind of nervous. That's just in here. Everybody know me. They say I speak, I get nervous. I might not look like it, but inside, trembling. It's heart beating like this, and like cardiac arrest going on up here. Because when you're up here, it's no joke. Be serious.
Amen.
Because there's people out there that's heartbroken, that's going through things, and we're here to help them. When we come for them and speak to them about who can relieve all that pressure, who can help them, who can deliver them, who can save them. So before I started, I had to say that is who I am. That's good. Get me where I need to be and just do what God asked me to do, because that's just who I am. That's how he have. And not that I'm a great singer, I just praise him through songs. Amen.
Amen.
You're a great singer.
Amen.
Praise him.
Yes.
Praise him.
Yes.
Praise him.
Yes.
Praise him.
Yes.
Jesus, blessed Savior, he's worthy to be praised. Come on and praise him. You ought to praise him. Praise him in the morning. Praise him in the noonday. Praise him. Jesus. Praise him, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I come before you to speak on what God has me to speak on and what I know and what I love to do for him.
Yes.
And that is praise and worship.
Come on now.
And, my topic is, I gotta praise him.
Yes.
I gotta praise him.
Yes.
I gotta praise him.
Yes.
See, his power is in that little title right there. I gotta praise him.
Come on now.
But before I start, I'm gonna go to my scripture that invited me to praise him. Amen.
Amen.
So it's coming from Psalm 7, verse 17. And it reads, I will thank the Lord because he is just. I will sing praise to his name of the Lord Most High. And that's all I got. Because that's all I do.
Yes.
Because that's just me right there. I have to give him thanks through my through songs.
Yes.
I got to sing it out. And that's what I do. I'm a worshiper through songs. And if you know my story, you'll know why I sing and do what I do.
Amen.
See, I got a book that's in the Bible, too, that's not written. But it's a book of in it. And it got some chapters and some verses in there that's there to help somebody.
Yes, ma'am.
Because of my life skills, because of what I've been through, and because of who I know that saved me. See, Bishop kind of touched on it a little bit, salvation. And I found out that salvation is free.
Yes.
Because God's Son, Jesus Christ, who died at Calvary, paid it all.
Come on now.
That's why it's free. You ain't got to pay for it. All you got to do is praise him.
Yes.
All you got to do is worship him. Because I found out his power in praise.
Yes.
I found out his power in worship. But see, first, I had to learn that what is praise and worship. But and then when you live it and you go through, even though you go to church, everybody don't know how to praise God and everybody don't know how to worship God.
Amen.
So I found out that praise is when you just fellowship with it.
Yes.
You know, when we go to the games and we fellowship, we all out there shouting, and hey, yeah, go, touchdown, good, you know, hey, where you live? You know, when you do all that stuff, We fellowshipping. We in the crowd. Just like we at church, we fellowshipping. I have never seen, like Bitch said in the Bible, where it said you got to have a membership.
Amen.
It says fellowship.
Yes.
That means you follow me, fellowship. So I said, okay, fellowship. So when I'm praising, I'm really fellowshipping.
Yes.
And I found out while I was praising him, I wonder why we always sing the band song doing it again. So I found out, I had to learn that, there's power. You be tired when the slow songs come. You know, there's cardio, you don't need all of it. You know, and you got to sing two more songs, and you can't get the breath, you forgot the word. And I'm like, why y'all ain't got to? But I found out because it's the fellowship that we have with God. So right there, we kind of throwing out who he is. Lord, it's power in the name. Can't nobody do it like Jesus. So now we giving all those accolades right now. We just giving it to him. We just praising him. See, we like that work at an elementary school. We got to have some praise words. You can't just be, go to work. You can't be going at them children like that.
That's right.
So you got to say, even Johnny made a mistake. You say, Johnny, hey, water, that might not be the word you spell, but I'm so glad you tried to spell the word, Johnny. Now, you know what you need to do? That was so awesome.
That's right.
But see, just like I said, Johnny was awesome. My God is awesome.
Okay.
He put that spirit in me to let him know, baby, even though you mess up, there's somebody to pick you up and turn everything around.
Yeah.
It don't matter how old you are. That's why I say you need to come as a child.
Yes.
All right,
come on.
You got to have a spirit like a child when you things go wrong and you look like you just was fighting like 5 minutes ago, now y'all playing with blocks. To the same boy, you know, pushed and told he stole. But now you playing with Johnny. And that's the lifestyle, and that's how God wants us to be for other people. Even though we might get mad and get upset, but he wants us to forgive.
That's right.
He wants us to forgive. So when you praising them for the good, you need to know how to praise them for what is not too good, but praise them and teach them how to get out of it and let them think about why.
Come on, Dad.
Why you did what you did.
Come on.
And so you got to, Then you put them in a little time, not just because they bad. You put them in time to let them think about
what had happened.
See, they got to know what time is for. Yes. Time out is not just the put you there because you're bad. Time out is there to let them think. And then they come back and find out, what can I do better the next time?
That's
what time out is for.
Right.
Not just to get rid of the bad seed that you think is bad. That's not what it is. That's why you have to teach. That's why you have to nurture.
Yes.
And then that's what praise and worship is. It's a nurturing to me.
Yes.
Because I had to find out, I had to have a fellowship. I had to do all of that. Well, baby, when it came to worship,
come on.
Let me tell you about worship. You know, when you get intimate. You get,
right.
You went on that loop up. Whoa, turn out the lights, baby, right? Hey, like a camp, because that's what they say.
Right,
a house is not a home.
Right,
you know when you're doing all that, you get all intimate. You setting up, you gonna set up. Oh, cook, I got no candles. It'd be only 5 minutes to be like them candles.
Right,
and those city candles, our smells, when he come in, that aroma. Ooh, got some little pillows coming out now. He said, ooh, we finna take a bubble bath. Ooh, what we finna do tonight? That's how you got to be intimate with God. In the same way. And you want people to say, you got to love on God.
That's right.
It ain't that. See, you looking at it in the carnal way. It ain't. It's a spiritual thing.
You, just call,
you gotta have a relationship because it's power in worship.
Yes.
You gotta have it when you think about what he did for you.
Yes.
But he just, how I got out of this when I know I couldn't get out of this pit. I couldn't get myself out of this. When somebody reached down and picked me up, and I ain't see the hand that picked me up when I saw myself coming out of the pit. And I was just coming out. And I ain't know why I was coming out. But I kept coming and coming and coming and coming. I praise you. See, I learned how to pray for worship for my mom and grandma.
Yes.
I I learned that. Even my daddy, I learned that. My daddy didn't go to church as much, but his spirit was there.
Yes.
His spirit was there. And then I grasped onto the spirit, and I just kept grasping onto it, and I just kept it.
Yes.
And then when after I had him, I got fast, I went back, so I said, you know, Lord, I'm going to go home. So that's my response. So I went home, started working and everything. Then I got married. Then I had my daughter. I said, oh, Lord, I got married. I was happy married. Then my friends tell this stuff. I ain't had no man to do it. That's how I made my husband. Because, you know, I'm going to tell it. I'm going to get that money off my back because nobody can tell that story better than me.
That's right.
You know, when y'all see these women come in, y'all got some pastors. See, I was a first lady, and you got pastor wives. But before that, I was just a member. But I didn't know why I had to go through that channel because I never did it before. I was like sheltered. I was the baby girl.
Yes.
I didn't know nothing. I really didn't. I really didn't know nothing. So, but the way I met my second husband was like, huh? And then what hurt it was, they're like my family kind of pushed me to him. When I know I should have been backing up, he was married. I ain't got no business in there. I'm in there to worship. All I know is worship. When I went in there, when I found out, it looked like I had did it, but it wasn't me. You know how it looked like that?
Yes.
You,
yes.
But it really wasn't me. I was the one supposed to stop it.
Yes.
I was the one supposed to stop that.
My God.
So I had to go through it.
Yes.
I was the one.
But
now you're going to mess up adultery. Oh, the girl that slept with the pastor don't mess up that. But that wasn't the truth. Cause it was doing it before me, but I ain't know. I was blind. I ain't know. I didn't know.
Come on.
So I was trying to back up, and the more I back up, I was steady going for it. Going. Back. Then we got married. I said, you know what, Lord? I really did. I got happy. We got things was good. Well, I tell you something. That last year before we got divorced, I said, something ain't right here. So I was so mad. He called and said, well, I gotta go to Ben. He was talking so nice. Go see Ben got some fish. I said, Mama, no, you ain't got to go. Yeah, so what we did, we was getting around 2,500. So it was like an hour on, it was a back door in there, so we had a big old, we had to call the house, so we was on that floor where it was like the house. We had a front and a back.
Yes.
But I called the back cave because that was my room where you could slip back through the closet and it was a back door right there.
Yes.
So I'm like, okay. And you know the little folding dinner chair? You sit.
Yes.
Pull up.
Yes.
So one of them was in the room, so he's like, I'm going. I said, where you going? I'm going. Nah, he ain't got it. My spirit knew something was right.
Right.
And I said, wait a minute. You know what? I'm going. I went out in the kitchen. I came back. I said, you know what? If you leave this house, it'll be me and you. I'm cleaning it up now. It's gonna be me and you. You ain't going to this. Oh, I'm going. I said, okay. And I thought about it. And I don't hit. I don't cut. I don't do that. So I got so mad. When I get mad, I just throw stuff. I don't throw at you. I just like release what's in me. They call me Carrie. You know how they move the carriage?
Yeah.
We got, that's me. That's their nickname. My children nicknamed me Carrie. They said, look at the wife. Look at my wife. I was like, every time I move, I was throwing something. I don't know what sprint came in our hand, and that was like real wood. And I got that table, and I said, whoosh. And it hit the wall, and you know, the legs, and it hung in the wall like this. It didn't tear up the wall. And I thought about it when I came off that little Tasmanian devil high. I came off and I looked.
Yeah.
Just hanging it. Just took the legs in the wall. And the flapped over on the wall. I said, but it didn't tear up the wall. So I took it out and it had two holes. The size of the table. It didn't tear it. that way. I said, nah, I want you to remember what that means right there. That's a sign right there. Yeah. I told you, don't play in the pulpit. That's why you don't preach about love, because you ain't loving at home. So you know what? So I'm going to tell you like this. You're
right,
love at home. So home represents you need to love at home. So what you do at home, you need to do it in the pulpit. Is he didn't keep mad at me because I never did it out in the open. I did it at home. So I said, well, whatever you do, it's going to come out. You love to preach. It's going to come out in the pulpit. And I kept it's gonna come out of church, whatever you do.
That's right.
That's right. Dang it, if it ain't come out in the church. He called the police on me. Cause I asked for the key to the church.
Oh Lord.
Yes it is.
Yes. Oh Lord.
Yes it is.
I had to go back then. You mad because I asked for the key that you had already gave me. I just said I need the key back because I know you're getting ready to leave and take the lady who I already know who we like, but I ain't saying that sitting in your office.
Lord.
Come on.
Lord.
So I already knew that. You can't lie to me. Okay, so there you go. You don't mess up another marriage, but that's what he do. You just mess that one up, and I'm going to say it like it's true. You mess me up, you mess that up, and you keep on messing up. Just messing up. So we were gonna mess up Rome that year. So when all that happened, called the police on me.
My Lord, my Lord.
But it backfired. So we had a team, and Bishop was our speaker. So I had a speaker. It was good. We had a good time.
Yes.
But so we knew something was different with him. He went all this. We knew something was different. So after that, we cleaned up. About 10 of us was in the church.
Yes.
We just cleaned up. Amen. I got to call. I got to handle some things. Now, you know why? I got to handle some things. I'm telling you, this is why I pray in worship. This way it really got to the worship part, this part of my life. And he said, oh, I got to handle some stuff. I keep doing something with the woman in the office. And you act like you handle it, but you're on the phone talking to somebody like you're going to handle something.
Okay.
So I was like, okay. I still, I didn't bust. I didn't rave. I didn't do none of that.
Right.
I came out. I said, y'all know he called the police on me just like that. I'm like, girl, stop lying. I'm lying. All of a sudden, you heard him. Don't nobody come back there. That's my church. Don't nobody. All this was going on.
Wow.
So the police came and I got my little stuff. So we were cleaning up. I'm walking out. I met the police. He said, hi, ma'am. I said, how you doing, officer? We went out. Couldn't get out there. Couldn't go because the police was behind me. Two cars. So after everything was over, they didn't even stay there long. I don't know, 5-10 minutes, they were gone. So when they came out, he came out to the door at the church. Nat, come here, the police want another police behind me. I can't leave. The police gone. They gone.
Yes.
But he telling me the police want me. But the police left. I'll be a fool and dummy and you raving to get out of my car. That is a lie. Okay. Left the church.
Yes.
That's how I still went home.
Yes.
And I thought about it. It ain't that happened. I thought about, man, you trying to mess my life up with that prank.
Yeah. Yeah.
I could have had a charge for domestic violence over a prank.
My God.
Because you possessed by whatever was in you that day.
Right.
So I'm praying, I'm telling the true story. Because I never said nothing mean about it.
Right.
You don't hear me talk bad about it. I ain't telling about leaving the church. I left.
Yes.
I wrote a letter. Put it in the mailbox because I didn't want to go back.
Right.
They told me they wanted me to reword that because they wouldn't, because they didn't look right because he's a bitch. I ain't rewording the truth.
Right.
That's right.
It's
right.
It's the
truth.
Right. It's time for all this nonsense. If y'all leaders can't stop it, I'm going to stop it.
Yeah,
it's time to stop. I'm the one supposed to stop it.
My
I went through that channel and buried. About to go to jail. Over some prank, cause you possess with loving on this messed up people's marriages.
We hear you, now. We hear you.
But you know the word, but you ain't living the word.
Yeah.
You ain't worshiping. Yeah. You ain't giving it all. So I learned to praise it.
Yeah.
I learned to worship it. Cause I serve a God that went on peppering his throat.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on, man.
And when they nailed him, they put him in his hand in because nobody could go over him. They couldn't go under him, and they definitely couldn't go around him. So I thank God right now. I worship him. I cry to him. It don't matter how I do it, but I pray for him. That's my praise to him. That's what I got to do to get my praise through, because he brought me out. Thank you that COVID praise him.
Yes.
I must praise him.
Yes.
A praise is what I do.
All right.
That didn't mean us no good. We praise. Why do we praise? Why do we worship? If you ever get to the basic, if you ever get to the basic of praise and worship, you'll feel what she felt.
Yes.
You'll know when God takes over, there ain't no. That's what happens. We wanna resurrect God, then we want to die down, and then we want to bring him back up, and then you'll put it back. That's why you be in church all day. You don't bring God back. God is already here and now.
Amen.
Amen.
When you get to the place of hearing what Jesus said to Philip in John 14:9, he said, "How long must I be with you?" He said, "If you have seen me, you have seen the Father. If you have seen me, you have seen the Father." I want you to hear this. And when you hear this, you take this with you.
Yes, sir.
Then I'm going to give you a reason to praise God when you wake up. Give you a reason to praise God when you snore.
I want to give you
a reason to praise God when you're mad.
Yes.
I want to give you a reason to praise God when things are good. I want to give you a reason to praise God when you don't want to praise Him. I want to give you a reason to praise God.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Come on.
on Philip.
That's right.
And so now I praise God.
Yes.
Because every time I see you, I see him. Every time I see you, I don't care what state I see you in, I know there's no you without God creating you.
Come on, man.
I praise him because he's here right now. I praise him because he's now. He's here. He's now. He's here. He's now.
Yes. Hallelujah. My God. Thank you.
You praise and you worship God. How long is it going to be before you can see that she is not without him? You are not without him. Your children are not without him. I am not without him. How much longer is it going to take before you really see who God is?
Come on now.
Where is he? He's right here. When? Now!
Come on now. Right now.
And she was talking about praise and worship. And it hit me. Jesus told Philip, he said, how long must I be with you? How long?
Come on.
Before you see my Father.
My Lord.
You are not without him.
Amen.
I am not without him.
Yes.
So I praise him because I am here.
Amen.
I praise him because guess what? When he put me here, he put me in the now, and the only thing I'm missing, this is why I raise so much hell, because I can't see my eternity.
My Lord.
If you understand you're here because of him,
yes.
You're living in the now because of him.
Yes.
All is about him, and everything connected to him is eternal, baby.
Hallelujah. Glory.
You ain't going nowhere once God started. Judas said, it said, whatever God starts, he finishes.
Amen.
But God didn't start us, he created us.
Glory.
So there's no finish to us.
Come on.
He said, whatever God starts, he finishes.
Hallelujah.
But God didn't start her. God didn't start me. He didn't start you. He created you.
Yes.
There is no finish to you. At all.
Glory, hallelujah.
Here and now, only thing that I'm missing is my forever right now.
My God.
I'm missing my forever God right now. My eternal Father right now. I am not here without him. You are not here without him. And he said, if you're here, you're with me right
now.
Come on, somebody.
Speak, Holy Ghost.
Come on, somebody.
Glory.
Come on, somebody. Slow this thing down. Ain't nothing worth me not seeing my forever and celebrating it when
right now.
You better talk to me.
Thank you, Holy
Ghost. You better talk to me. You better talk to me.
Thank you,
she
God.
She found her right now. And when you with God, ain't no police, ain't no devil, ain't no fake hood.
Come on now.
You know what I'm trying to tell you? Ain't nothing gonna stop you.
Nothing. Come on.
I want to tell you something, man. I'm gonna take a seat because you don't preach. God said he gonna bring, and I really want the ladies to hear this. God said he gonna bring in your life. He said, when I'm in your life, there is an increase. When I'm in your life, not a man, on the ladies to hear this. When I'm in your life, there is an increase. Because who brings the increase?
God.
So God put a man in your life, and there's an increase. Hold on to that man.
That's right.
I don't care what the circumstances are. But I'm going to tell you this. And I ain't talking about money. I ain't talking about houses. I'm not talking about cars. But if there's a man in your life and there's a decrease, find that little cut she found and get out that back door.
That's right. That's right.
Because if there's a decrease, God ain't in it, baby.
That's right.
Y'all hear what I just said?
Yes.
But we don't want to see the truth because we got to have a man.
Uh-oh.
The kind we want. If nothing is not increasing, y'all gonna keep decreasing because God ain't
in it.
Helping somebody.
All right, now you better preach.
Are you saying anything?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Power.
Yes.
Hit it.
Yes, sir.
Fellas, you want to keep a lady? Make sure you position yourself with God so there can be an increase.
Amen. Yes.
And I ain't talking about things. It's a spirit increase. And I'm going to tell you like this. You need all the help you can with a woman. Women, you need all the help you can with a man. I can't stay with no woman without God.
Amen.
Can no woman stay with me without God?
Amen.
How many relationships you been in and out of? Think about how many was born of God. Come on. We need help with each other.
Amen.
Come on now.
Are we talking about it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
We need help. What God said, and I always thought I needed my wife. I always thought I needed a man, a friend, or a woman as a wife. But God said it's not good for man to be alone. And when I heard that, I thought he gave Adam to Eve, but he said it's not good for man to be without me.
That's right.
Amen.
That's
it's not
right.
Good for man to be alone without God.
You better hear what I'm talking about.
When he said it's not good for man to be alone, and a woman can't do for me what God can do for me. You better hear what I said. A friend can't do for me what God can do for me. And he said it's not good for man to be alone. He said, don't try this thing without me now. I gave you a playmate, but don't you try this without me. Don't you try this without me. I ain't talking about nothing. Don't you try this without me now. When he said it's not good for man to be alone, I thought I needed a woman. Come on, somebody. When he said it's not good for man to be alone, I thought I needed a best friend. Come on, somebody. But what I didn't hear, what I should have heard, it ain't good for man to be alone without God. It ain't good for man to be alone without God.
Amen.
Especially when he's right here, right
now.
You better hear me.
Come on now.
Especially when he's right here, right now.
Amen. My God.
Yeah. Do y'all think he was talking about people?
Yeah.
But he ain't said it until he gave him Eve. And then he said, it's not good for man to be alone. He gave him Eve. Now don't fool yourself. I'm going to talk about her. Not good for you to be without me. Thank you for your praise and worship, sir. Give my hand again. Give my hand again. I have something, but after that, all I would do is get in the way of what God's already said. Amen?
Yeah.
You got to know when to hold them and know when to fold them.
That's right.
You got to know when to speak and know when to shut up.
That's right. Amen, man.
Oh, my God. Yes.
Glory to God. My God, my God.
I'm going home.
My God, my God.
We're going home.
God,
but all I can hear, I want you to just close your eyes and just think about your life. And think about all the times that you called it turmoil. And think about where was God? All the disasters that you went through. Where were you with God? Were you in a place where you were serving God, looking for a church to go to, couldn't wait to get up and go to church, or not? Where was God in all your turmoil? You was alone without Him. Because every circumstance you went through when God was in it, it didn't last very long. Come on, somebody. Every time you went through a circumstance and God wasn't in it, seemed like it was never going to get. That's right. It was never going to end. Anybody hear anything tonight?
Yes.
Anybody hear? This is where I think about it. This is where I need to be.
Amen.
Somebody say, devil?
Devil?
You should have killed me?
You
should have
killed me.
Before I know what I know. You should have killed me before I know what I know. That was somebody. Before I know what I know. Give me you. Everything else can wait. Give me you. I hope it's not too late. Lord, give me you. Lord, give me you. Lord, give me you. Yourself in your relationship with God.
Yes.
I thank you right now, God. I thank you for this minister. I thank you for this ministry.
Yes.
I thank you for our pastor. I thank you for the members.
Yes.
I thank you for those who came to the altar yesterday and made a commitment to you, and they honored that commitment by returning today and said, this is my norm. Everybody also always talk about a new norm. Make God your new norm.
Yes, man.
Make God your new norm.
Yes.
We're in our new norm, baby. I've been in mine because God has been my new norm before Corona, during Corona, and after Corona. Yes. Make God your new norm. We thank you now, Father.
Thank you.
As we get ready to leave this place, we will not leave the spirit that we were fed from this minister tonight.
Yes, God.
You are our new Lord. You are right here with us right now. I'm not praying because I got something. I'm praying because of who I'm with.
Yes.
I wouldn't even be here without God.
Yes.
He said, you think I'm going to bring you somewhere as bad as earth and not go down there with you? We're in the midst of God right now.
Yes.
Yes.
The Spirit of the Living God said, this is a new season. This is a new season. Anybody who walks in this season, your leaf shall never wither from this day forward. If you honor what you have given God into this night, you have given God a praise of thanking you for bringing me here. You have given God a worship of thank you for being with me right now. And because now I can see you, Jesus. Now I can see you, Minister. Now I can see you, Elect. Now I can see you, Minister Turner. And I can see you because God made you. That means I've got to be able to see God. So as we leave this place, we ask you to send out your guardian angels to watch over us in our appropriate dwelling places. And send out your traveling angels to watch over us along the dangerous highways and byways. And we'll be sure to give you all the honor and all the glory as we leave you with God's prayer for his children. My children, which are on earth,
my kingdom is your kingdom. I am nourishing you daily. I gave you life today, so you add to the life of others. I have forgiven your trespasses, so you can forgive the trespasses of others. I have delivered you from temptation by leading you into purpose. So don't live to love, rather love to live.
You are dismissed.
Amen. Amen.